It's so important to live very close to the Holy Spirit in these times. It's so easy to be deceived if you're not living warm, if you're not living in the truth. It's easy to be deceived. The enemy is placing his way very close to God's way of truth. Sometimes I see people in churches even be deceived out into the New Age world. And it's that big deception thought that it is basically the same, because they lack knowledge how dangerous it is. I'm going to talk a little bit today about deception, how easy it is for even a church girl like me to be deceived. We all have friends who are spiritual seekers. They maybe are. Many of us have friends that are in New Age. I don't know if all of you Christians out there know what the New Age movement stands for. You should look it up. You should look it up. You should study it a little bit. But be very careful, because it's strong powers in that belief system, that is mixing Jesus, yes, even the Holy Spirit. But what they don't believe in is the risen Christ, the resurrection, the salvation that only Jesus can provide. If they don't preach that, stay away from it. You know, I have, as I said, people around my life that I really love. Some of them I don't have that much contact with right now. It's just God who's been shifting my circles the last years, because I need strong, powerful, anointed men and women around my life in my inner circle. But I have, you know, I'm in contact with them from time to time. And before, when I used to hang with them a little bit more, I knew what I was believing in. I knew my belief system, and I was certain that I am, you know, I'm protected. I know that they are deceived. I always knew that. But then I started changing my words when I was hanging with these beautiful people, because many of them are fantastic people. There's nothing wrong with them as human beings. It's just they are sliding away into a deception. They are deceived by the enemy. And the enemy wants to deceive us as Christians too into this movement or this way of thinking, and he can use many years of our lives to slowly take us out into that way of thinking. You start with changing your words. You know you mean the power of God, but you say energy, and you start to use their expressions as a saved person. And it's something wrong right there. I'd done it, but I had to repent from it, because God basically took me in my ears and said, Elena, be very careful. Know what you believe in and be determined. Be wise, be full of love, but at the same time, don't spread yourself so thin that you don't know that you are slowly moving into their direction, starting with your words. And then you just, you know, the enemy, he tries to make that world and that thinking seem so innocent. Some of the things, like crystals, for example, those stones, that many New Age people believe in, where you put them on the chakra system. It's very Hinduistic thinking. And it's not for us. Not at all. It's very demonic. And I have been given presents with these crystals. Beautiful pink stones that are supposed to attract love. Doesn't that seem, sounds nice? You know, it sounds like it's nothing wrong with that. People came and gave it to me here in my apartment. And they said, we got a message from God that you should have these stones to attract love. You should put them in four different corners of your apartment, and it will bind the energy in your apartment. It's all very demonic and deceptive. And I didn't know what to do, so I received those stones because I felt sorry for the woman that gave that present to me. They're quite expensive too, and they're beautiful. But I knew that I could never have those stones in my house. You may think that I sound ridiculous and super spiritual now, but I'm not. I done yoga for years, and I defended that until God told me that I was doing Hinduism, that I was practicing worship positions with my yoga positions that was to Hindu gods, to idols. I was idol worshipping Hindu gods. There are over 5,000 Hindu idols. And yoga is also a deception. So I quit immediately, of course. And then these stones, I throw them in the garbage. I didn't tell the woman that I did it. But I did it because, you see, all these things that doesn't mean anything special to us because we have Christ. We have Jesus, we have, you know, the Bible, and we have the truth. So we think when we are friends with these people that it's okay to have a little Buddha statue at home. It's okay to have a little bit from that world. It's okay to have some books that are on the borderline between Christianity and something very occult. But it's coming in a deceitful way. So you think it's like, okay, maybe you're not even going to read those books. You're just going to look into them because you're curious. And you may be thinking, maybe I should just study it a little bit so I can help those people. Yeah, maybe, but be very careful. So I have been given books, expensive books, objects that are like, you know, a nice little thing that I had in my shower for to hold the soap. It's a frog. It's sitting in a yogi position. And for me, it's like a stone. It doesn't mean anything until God waked me up in the middle of the night for some years ago. And I was in a 30 days strong prayer and fasting to seek deeper into God. And he woke me up and he told me to clean my bookshelves. And I just had to go and pick out all the books that was given to me from my friends about yoga, about, you know, the enemy comes through the health thing now. Everything about health, you know, it's linked to something spiritual in there somewhere. So you can end up with shamanism if you're not careful. Astrology, fortune tellers, angel cards. Some churches even have that to sell. Angel cards is the same as tarot cards. Only is an angel on that card. It's witchcraft. And because Christians doesn't know And if you are in a church that is a little conservative with the supernatural, you can easily be driven out into the supernatural through New Age on the internet. I'm just warning you. Don't have anything to do with stones, crystals, any objects. What do you call it? The Indians have it. It's dream catcher. You know, you put it over your bed. All those stuff seem innocent, okay? It's beautiful, you know, it doesn't mean anything demonic to you. But you see, those things, God told me, they are objects that are linked to something spiritual. If they were not linked to it, they would just be a regular stone that you could have in your window as a beautiful decoration. But you can't have it because those stones have a purpose in the spiritual realm. They are used to something, to attract energy, to attract demonic influence, which people who in New Age doesn't know. They think it's energy. It's actually a lot of it. It's demonic. It's a big, big, big deception. And if you mix Jesus, you mix Buddha, all the religion in that ball, you feel safe. You feel that, you know, I included Jesus. I believe in Jesus. He was a great healer. And I believe in love. And then you're deceiving yourself. And you have these friends who are trying to save you into New Age. They're actually doing it by giving you stuff. And it's so strong powers. Bam, suddenly you're sitting there with a lot of objects that are connected to the demonic world. And you're saved. You maybe even be a preacher. So be very careful. Be very careful and study it a little bit. Because, as I said, some Christians that I know, they have been driven into, especially the younger generation, into more of the supernatural, which they think it's okay. Even astral projection, which is out of body experience. And they think that they are flying around, praying for cities, seeing angels and stuff. And they think it's really angels. It's not angels, it's disguised demons. Actually, when you have an astral projection, there are a certain demon coming and picking your spirit out of your body, taking you up to the spiritual realm. It's nothing to do with God. It's demonic. It's witchcraft. You're opening yourself up for demons big time. It's super dangerous. So that world, it's so powerful. I had people in my Bible study here that they were curious. They knew that I was spiritual. And I was a little coward because that spirit is so strong and you don't want to lose those people as your friends. So you are using other words and you're flirting a little bit with that spirit, actually. But you don't know that before, after. So I was having a Bible study in my house where a lot of women from that belief system came to me because I had called it a spiritual group. And God said to me, you cannot call it a spiritual group. When they hear it spiritual, they think it is the same. They think it is a buffet of religion that you are going to represent, that everything is allowed here, like a New Age group. And God said, you cannot do this. You have to stand up straight and tell it like it is. You have to tell those people that this is about me. that this is a Bible study about Jesus Christ and the Bible. And I'm telling you guys, even if I've been saved all my life, it cost me something. Even as a leader of a Bible study, it cost me something. I had a struggle saying that to those people. I thought they were going to leave, you know, all of them. But so what? Now I'm thinking, so what? Let them go. I need to tell the truth. And to tell the truth and stand in the truth is one day going to cost us more and more and more. To be radical is going to cost you, but at the same time, you're going to be so powerful and anointed if you are living a radical life. So those deceitful spirits are coming to all of us through the health thing, mindfulness, you know, meditation. It's not the same as the meditation when we say we meditate on the Word of God. It's not. When those people talk about meditation, they are still and they are emptying their brain. You know how dangerous that is to empty your brain? You have no protection here. And every thought, when you meditate on those terms, means that every thought that is coming to your mind, you're going to receive it, let it go through your mind and out. Can you imagine how many demons are taking advantage of that? Of course they are. I see ministers compromising with their ministry because of people entering into their lives that are heavy in New Age, where they slowly, where they for many years ago said, I will never compromise with the gift God has given me. And now they are compromising. They are living more and more in that world. Because the enemy, he can use years to drag you out in your way of thinking. So what you didn't like for 5-10 years ago, where you were sharp, now you think it's okay. It's not so bad. It's not so bad at all. To have a homosexual marriage, it's, you know, maybe it's okay. Maybe it's natural. Maybe I'm just judgmental. Maybe I shouldn't say anything against that, you're thinking. But it's going to cost us to be radical, to be against abortion, to stand up for the truth. But it's the only thing that's going to liberate people. So that night when I told my friends, listen, guys, I know that there are a lot of religions, I said to them, and I cannot, you know, preach that here. I'm just preaching Jesus to you guys and the Bible. That's all we're going to talk about in this group. We're not going to talk about Buddha or all other religions here. I'm just going to talk about my beliefs, that is Christ Jesus and the gospel. And the moment I said it, it was like the Holy Spirit came in the room and cut the atmosphere like a knife. And all of a sudden, the anointing was so heavy because I stood up for Jesus. And it cost me something, but God backed me up, people. And two of those women fell on their knees and said, give me Jesus. We want what you have. I need a Bible, they said. And all of them are saved now. All of them are saved. You see how important it is to stand up for the truth? Don't flirt with that world. Don't flirt with crystals. Don't think that it's innocent. It's not. Don't flirt with objects. Don't have anything of that stuff in your house because it's linked to something. I've been to people's houses that are beautiful Christian families, and I saw they have dream catchers. They had Egyptian idols there from Egyptians, Egypt and stuff like that. And I had to tell them, I said, it's disturbing the atmosphere in your house. It's linked to something. You're more attacked. And one of those people in that, or actually several of that family member were very attacked in their sleep by stuff they couldn't control. So God wants us to live in peace. He wants us to be protected, but we need to be firm and stand up for the truth, people, and not be deceived by angel stuff. I mean, we love angels too. We're not worshiping angels. You are not an angel. I am not an angel. We are human beings. We fall in sin. We need grace. Don't be fooled by that thinking, please. And I just pray, I want to pray right now because I feel this is really on my heart and on God's heart. It's such a time where it's so much deceitful spirits going on also in churches about this, where they have Christian yoga. It's no such thing, actually. Christian yoga, it's just deception. Even if you have the Betel worship on when you're doing yoga, it doesn't help. Because it's what you do with your body. Remember Daniel? He didn't want to fall down to the statue of Nebuchadnezzar. So they put him into the fiery furnace for it. But God protected him supernaturally. And God is going to protect you. Don't fear the consequences of standing up for Jesus Christ. God and all heaven is going to back you. Yeah? Jesus is going to back you. The power of God is going to surround your life. And you're thinking that's also demonic. Oh, I'm going to be unpopular. I'm going to lose people. I'm going to lose money. I'm going to be isolated. And they're going to talk about me, thinking that I'm judgmental or looking everything in black and white. Okay, so that's called persecution. So you have to swallow it. You can't stop being radical and stand up for the truth because you're afraid of what people will think about you. Because it is what God is saying about you that matters. And he's going to back you. If you are not ashamed of Jesus, he's not ashamed of you either. It says a word in the Bible, if you are ashamed of him, one day he will be ashamed of you. You have to stand up for your belief. For me, it's so ridiculous. I'd rather be in the world. I mean, if I can't stand up for what I believe in and given my life to, so why? I mean, and I have to compromise with my belief system? No. I believe in this 100%. Really, really, I'm proud of Jesus. I'm proud of being a Christian. I know this is the truth. So why should I compromise with what I have been given my life to please my friends and to not have enemies? You're still going to have enemies. You're going to have a worse time if you compromise. It's dangerous to compromise. It's really dangerous because you're opening yourself up for, you're making an agreement, that's what you're doing, with darkness on some little areas of your life. And you know what that little area will do? It will grow. The enemy will take advantage of that little hole in the wall in your life because you allowed it. You open yourself up for it. You acknowledge it. You made an agreement with it. You actually said without words, this is okay. It's okay. I am not them, but I'm, you know, I respect, you know, it's nothing dangerous with crystals or yoga or whatever. You know, I know what I believe. I was thinking like that too. I did yoga for many, many years. I was pretty good at it. And I was praying to Jesus while I was doing yoga there on the floor. Until God, after many years, managed to come through because no person could tell me to stop doing yoga. I got almost rebellious. I said, you don't know what you're talking about. I know that this is just good for my body. I was defending it for years until God showed me supernaturally it was the only way for me to listen and really believe that this was a deception, was when Jesus came through and said, you are doing something that is very occult with your body right now. You're opening yourself up for a big deception here. And some months later, because that position I was doing in the yoga, I started to question it. Haven't I seen it in a statue somewhere? I was thinking like that. And then when the Holy Spirit came through, I couldn't stay in the yoga class. I had to go home. In the middle of the class, I just left. 2 months after, I was in Turkey. And I was up on the mountain in a little shop where they had, you know, small things to decorate with and stuff. And I saw this woman, this idol, Hinduistic woman on a shelf, standing in the same position as I did in the yoga class. And then, you know, that's my, I don't need more confirmation. Actually, I knew it before I saw that statue. I knew because God told me, and I know when he's speaking to me. I knew that I'd been totally blinded. So be careful, my friends, my brothers and sisters in the body of Christ. Don't flirt with that world. Stand up for the truth. And people will be free and you will stay protected. Okay? That's my word today. God bless you. Bye.